comics verse is here to answer the question that has been burning in Everion, Esmin Sinchel. 1988, is Die Hard really a Christmas movie? For this first installment of comics verse the debates, we brought into, pardon the pun, Die Hard film fans to argue their very strong opinions on the matter. Not a Christmas movie by Sarah Hartzell. Die Hard is a Christmas movie, dot for about 15 minutes. The first act of the movie sets up a Christmas movie you would happily watch. A hard-damned New York reunites with his estranged wife and children. Until they learn to be a family again through a sad near-death experience and so may Bing Crosby. Tours but any semblance of Christmasness is abandoned as second-hand Gruber and Co. arrive. It becomes a straightforward action movie. Albeit one of the best action movies of all time and one I gladly watch year-round. But an action movie first and foremost, not a Christmas movie. I am not saying there can te be genre Christmas movies titles like KRAMPUSNTNIGHTMARE BFORECHRISTMAS PROFTA TERTUAREN TE MUTUALI EXCLUSIVE. But for a movie to be a Christmas movie it must meet one of two criteria. It must necessarily take place at Christmas time through imagery or plot. Or it must expose Christmassy values, like selflessness and family. Die Hard does neither of the settings. Just another day at the office. To the former, Die Hard does not have to take place at Christmas. While it might be the initiating event for the film, it could essentially be any other holiday or life event that brings John McClane to Laen. Nakatomi Plaza, New Year's a promotion for Holly at. And the importance of it being Christmas is null throughout the rest of the movie. Notable Christmas imagery is sparse. And the fact that it is Christmas plays little role in the plot. It is not like John is saving Christmas by stopping the bad guys. As it easily could have been, none of the decisions made intend or reflect it as a Christmas movie. Hell, it was originally released in July. Lack of Christmas spirit. Second, there is nothing Christmassy about the spirit of Die Hard. Neither we nor John learn a lesson or improve as people by the end of the movie. John starts off as an ass and has ties and as it as we will of him. He reunites with his wifey but it is not through any kind of change or sacrifice on John's part. He never addresses his issue with his wifey having a successful career or his inability to be flexible. There is no I-S-A-W-O-N-D-E-R-F-U-L life moment where he learns his importance as a person or his effect on others or whatever. He doesn't te learn to be a better man or father. He just kicks us and takes names with his great, but it does not a Christmas movie make. Think about the experience you desire when you sit down to watch a Christmas movie. You want to get into that spirit. That ineffable Christmas mindset where everything just feels better surrounded by people you love and with a cup of hot chocolate in hand and the jingle of sleigh bells rings in your ears. Either hauntingly or pleasantly, your choice Die Hard does not do that. Watch it in December because it is a damn good movie, but not because it is a Christmas movie. Definitely a Christmas movie by Brian Long. Die Hard is a Christmas movie. I know that it has become hip or ironic to say that now. Oh haha, this 80s action movie is a representative of a major religious celebration. However, I say this with total and complete sincerity. I believe that Die Hard is not only a Christmas movie, but one of the best Christmas movies. Before I state my case, I think it is important to address how we define a Christmas movie. The first and most obvious rule is that the majority of its action must take place during the Christmas season. Second, Christmas must play a significant role in the plot of the film. It should be so significant that the film's plot would not work or require severe reworking to function. Finally, the film must use the Christmas season to examine the major themes of Christmas. I am not talking about pausing for a monologue about Jesus looking at you peanuts Christmas special. From a purely secular standpoint, it should be about family, giving, community, love for your fellow man, all that jazz. Yeah, no, the kind of stuff that was actually important to Jesus. Not making sure a Starbucks cup said Merry Christmas on it, but I digress. Reviewing the Christmas canon. This seems like a low bar, but there are some major holiday classics out there that don't really fit with these basic criteria. It is a wonderful life is a great classic American film. It usually creating like 15 minutes in. But is it really a Christmas movie? Sure, the major moment of the film takes place on Christmas. But it doesn't necessarily have to. It is a wonderful life is about the entire life of one man that happens to culminate on a Christmas Eve. The people of Bedford Falls have given George Bailey his missing money during a Juli 4th BBQ. Films like Miracle on 34th Street are presented as Christmas films, but barely address the important themes of the season. Miracle plays like an extended commercial for Machi S. Rather than as a proper film. It is considered a Christmas movie just because it takes place on Christmas. In reality, it is about a lawyer who is trying to prove that a guy claiming to be Santa Claus is actually Santa Claus. At best, the movie has a huge plot hole because if the guy really is Santa Claus, then how does he function in a world that doesn't think he is real? At worst, it is a movie about a lawyer enabling a man who is mentally ill and thinks he is Santa, so he can get into the pants of a woman he is interested in. Merry Christmas, everyone. If Miracle on 34th Street, the capitalist, as platonic ideal of a Christmas movie, can be part of the canon of holiday classics, we can say Die Hard, he'll be home for Christmas. Let us begin by looking at how Christmas functions within the plot. Our hero, New York City cop John McClane, Bruce Willis, is visiting California to visit his estranged wife Holly, Bonnie Bedelia, for the holidays. Immediately, we are beginning to see how this film uses the holiday for plot and thematic reasons. John and Holly are undergoing a trial separation while Holly takes on a new job for Tenaka Tommy Corporation. John has not seen Holly since she moved out there. What is the inciting incident bringing them back together, Christmas? This might seem negligible, but there are arguably fewer events that would make John travel across the country. The time of puts John into Holly's place of work for the company Christmas party. Again, it also justifies with the employees of the Nakatomi would be in the office late into the evening. From a thematic standpoint, the heart uses Christmas in a similar fashion as a Christmas carol. We have one man at your museum of sorts being forced to face the mistakes of his past. Ultimately, he must choose if he will change his ways for the better or continue to act. Selfishly, Christmas is a holiday centered around family reunion. Asuk McClan as reunion with his estranged wife forces him to reflect on just how he treated her. The Heart is a Christmas movie because of the holiday setting and its thematic exploration of family, empathy, and self-sacrifice. Not Christmasy enough. Sarah Hartzell kurung buka SH kurung tutup. A Christmas party is certainly the easiest way to get John and Holly in Nakatomi Plaza at the same time. But after that point, it really doesn't matter that it is Christmas in terms of plot or theme. Even so, meeting as minor as John incorporating a Christmas tree or a toy is for thoughts been into his as kicking what best asonal enough to dim the heart a Christmas movie, but we don't get that. Instead, Christmas is nothing more than the setting. I know it tend to play devil as advocate when it comes to men in movies, it is how you wrote most of my colleague papers, but I stand by my claim that John does not embody any family values tanda merek dagang that one expects from Christmas movies. His reasons for separating from Holly are extremely selfish. You thought she wasn't gonna make it out here and say they come crawling back to you. So we bother to pack, as Argyle puts it. John is definitely a potential scrooge in this story, but without the redemption Holly bends by letting him stay at her house, but John makes no such sacrifices. She even has a moment of vulnerability by saying she missed him. And her response with some crake about using her maiden name and taking his money. John's relationship with Officer Powell is far more well-rounded and respectful than with his wifey. The emotional backbone of the movie is how they improved a hot hair. John's even honest with Powell about his broken marriage in a way hasn't with Holly. The only sacrifice or empathy John shows is befitting terrorists and saving innocent people. If that is enough to qualify as a Christmas movie, then every action movie would be a Christmas movie. Classic Christmas plus explosive as Brian Long, BHI would say that John's experience evicting the terrorists is his own variation scrooge as visit with the three ghosts. John McClane's journey is less about changing and more about realizing how he had taken his family for granted all this time. Let's even consider Hans Gruber Alan Rickman, who fits beautifully into the archetypal Christmas story antagonist. Gruber, like scrooge, the Grinch, and Potter before him is an agent of pure avarice. Gruber, as anti-replot revolves around posing as a terrorist in order to manipulate the police force. Gruber masks his desire for capital gain behind a veneer of ideology. He is a personification of Christmas commercialism. McClane has to stand against an avatar of selfishness in order to purge himself of his own self-centered behaviors. It is a classic Christmas character arc. Only by going through the Gruber gauntlet can John prove that he truly loves his family. All of this is brought on by the spirit of Christmas. Like scrooge or the Grinch, he sees the error in his ways and realizes he must become a more loving, caring person. Beyond that, Christmas also plays an important role in how John figure the terrorists. Through the film Dusen, they indulge in Christmas theme karena ge as inventively as Sarah describes. Above, however, let us not forget the iconic "Now I have a machine gun, ho ho ho, swear it." Let us also not forget McClane's final confrontation. What does he use to hide his gun in order to get the drop on Gruber and his way? Lois resembling go on, none out her tan Christmas wrapping paper. McClane literally wins the day because of Christmas wrapping paper. What could make it more of a Christmas movie than that? Final togat? SH if you have to react for split second details and extended analogies to make up for that. Hit you in the face, all encompassing feeling of Christmas spirit. Tenet is not a Christmas movie. BL, I can know a Christmas movie when I see one. The heart is as Christmas as they come, and the world is a better place for its utility the action. What do you think? Does the heart fit the bill for Christmas movies? Yes. Or is it an action movie with a couple of ho-ho-hos? Cast your vote in the comments.